हाय फ्रेंड्स, गुड इवनिंग। दिस इज डॉक्टर हरिनाथ रेड्डी, डायरेक्टर शंकरन ए स्टडी सर्कल। इन द लास्ट वीडियो ऑन ऑल इंडिया जुडिशियल सर्विस वी विल सी द आर्गुमेंट्स विच आर अगेंस्ट द एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ ऑल इंडिया जुडिशियल सर्विस। सी, इफ यू रीड द आर्टिकल्स ऑन एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ ऑल इंडिया जुडिशियल सर्विस, देर आर वेरी स्ट्रांग आर्गुमेंट्स अगेंस्ट द एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ ऑल इंडिया जुडिशियल सर्विस। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट आर्गुमेंट विच इज मेड अगेंस्ट the establishment of all india judicial service is, in the era of decentralization, if you see, in 1992 we witnessed the amendments to the indian constitution in the form of 73rd amendment, 74th amendments to the indian constitution, providing for the establishment of rural and urban local self governing institutions with the constitutional status. So when there is greater focus on decentralization, the power to recruit the judicial officers of the subordinate judiciary, if it is entrusted to a central agency, as in the case of All India Judicial Service, it will be a retrograde step. It will be a retrograde step. This is the first criticism. In addition to this, so far, on the recruitments to the subordinate judiciary, the High Court had the power. Even if the State Public Service Commission is involved in recruiting the judicial officers below the district judge, the final word is with the High Courts. So High Courts, whatever they recommend, it is binding on the governor and also the State Public Service Commissions with respect to recruitment of the judicial officers of the subordinate judiciary in that particular state. But if this power is entrusted to a central agency by taking it away from the High Courts, this amounts to centralization, which is a retrograde step. In addition to this, it will undermine the independence of the High Court is one more argument. You know that judicial independence is one of the basic features of the Indian Constitution, as held by the Indian Supreme Court in several cases from time to time. So probably after the establishment of All India Judicial Service is done, taking away the powers of the High Court for recruiting the district judges of the subordinate judiciary, there could be petitions which can be challenged before the Supreme Court, saying that this will compromise the judicial independence at the state level. And in addition to this, there are several state high courts which are against this proposal. And as I told you, as per the observations made by M.N. Venkatachalaya Commission, and as per the amendments done by the 42nd Constitutional Amendment Act for Article 312, providing for Class 3, it says that the district judge post shall be recruited through an All India competitive examination through All India Judicial Service. But the problems which I have earlier told, if a young law graduates in the age group of 25 to 30 years, if they are selected through an All India competitive examination, even if the best were recruited through an All India competitive examination, soon after training they will be manning the post of district judge, and the post of district judge will deal with several serious criminal cases like murder and dacoity, and the district judge will also have appellate jurisdiction over civil and criminal cases which are decided by the judicial officers below him. And in addition, the district judge will also have original jurisdiction, not by appeal, with respect to certain civil matters. So all these are huge responsibilities which can be better handled through greater experience. So the question is whether these fresh recruits will be able to deal with such responsibilities at the post of the district judge is one fear which is expressed even by M.N. Venkatachalaya Commission, that is the National Commission to Review the Working of the Indian Constitution. But on the contrary, even if we recruit the All India Judicial Officers for the post of judicial officers below the district judge, then they will have sufficient time to get train and to gain experience before they become the district judge. But the question is, even at the lowest level in the subordinate judiciary, if the recruitments are done by a central agency, that amounts to centralization and also taking away the powers of the High Court, which is again against the judicial independence. So, and this needs a number of amendments to Article 233, 234 and 235. And in the context of judicial independence being the basic feature of the Indian Constitution, we don't know the judicial tenability of these amendments. If they are challenged before the Supreme Court on the ground that they take away the independence of judiciary at the state level, then all these amendments can be struck down by the Supreme Court. And as usual, the other important objections against creation of All India Judicial Service is All India Judicial Officers, after they are recruited, there is no guarantee that they will be posted in their own state. Like the All India Service Officers, they may be assigned to the states in which they don't know the language of the state and also the customs of the state. So that might affect the efficiency of the subordinate judiciary is one criticism. But as I told you, All India Service Officers, despite being posted in the states which are not the home states of the officers, there was no problem of efficiency. Possibly, even with respect to All India Judicial Service, ignorance of language and customs could be overcome in course of time, and that shall not be a big problem. But as of now, in all the states are below the level of High Court, all the district judge posts, they will be occupied through promotion by the judicial officers below the post of district judge. But if All India Judicial Service becomes a reality, say for example, National Judicial Pay Commission, the first National Judicial Pay Commission has recommended 25% of the posts, 25% of the posts of the district judges shall be recruited through an All India Competitive Examination. So that means to the extent of 25%, the judicial officers below the district judge will be denied to get promoted to these district judge posts through promotion. That will create a kind of heartburn for these judicial officers, and that may also bring in the issue of the sons of the soil in the state politics. In addition to this, in the era of decentralization, when the center is exerting more and more powers, and that too because of the 42nd Amendment, 5 items in the state list were moved to the concurrent list, and in the era of decentralization, is it necessary to give away the powers of the High Court at the state level to an agency at the central level is one more question which needs to be answered. In addition to this, through an All India Competitive Examination, if the officers, judicial officers of the subordinate judiciary are recruited, then those SCs, STs, OBCs who are dominant, who are otherwise more advantaged and more educated at the national level, will be able to take advantage because of this All India Competitive Examination. And as a result, there will be a problem for these marginalized communities in the respective states to get a share in the All India Judicial Service officer positions. And in addition to this, there was a judgment of the Supreme Court that these marginalized communities, ST, SC, OBC, they can get reservation only in the state where they are domiciled as ST, SC, OBC. So possibly, an SC in the state of Uttar Pradesh may not be eligible to get appointed as an All India Judicial Officer in some other state under the category of the reservation of SC. So all these problems also exist. So finally, we can conclude saying that as there are disagreements between different stakeholders for the establishment of All India Judicial Service, and there are several genuine concerns against the establishment of All India Judicial Service, unless the time is opportune in the form of wider consensus and also very less disagreements among the stakeholders, till then, bringing in reforms in the existing method of recruitment will seem to be a more feasible option in the short run.